Greetings, Bill Nye here. I am very excited to tell you that I'm today's celebrity substitute.
What if I told you that cloning could cause the end of the human race? I'm Jiyoon Kim. I'm from Oakland, California, where I teach biology. And today, we're going to be studying genetic variation and natural selection. But I have a special guest to help me teach this lesson. Today's celebrity substitute is Bill Nye. Hi, Bill.
Greetings, Ms. Kim.
How are you doing?
I'm fabulous. We're quarantined. I'm here in the kitchen.
I'm in my bedroom.
That's right.
Last time, though, I thought it was so fun walking through the history of Earth's timeline.
I am exhausted. I walked 3,000 miles.
You did.
I'm whooped.
Dedication.
But anyway, today we're going to talk about something else, yeah?
We're moving on to genetic variation and natural selection.
Well, that makes me want a banana. All the bananas we eat nowadays are clones.
And a clone is an organism produced asexually from one ancestor, to which it is genetically identical.
And that's what enables farmers to raise tremendous number of bananas on a plantation, but it also could put our banana supply at risk.
And in order to understand how this cloned banana could wipe out all bananas forever, we need to understand genetic variation.
Genetic variations, things that change in nature, whether you have brown eyes, blue eyes, are a result of the random nature of genes when organisms like you and me and funguses and oak trees reproduce. But what happens in nature, and this is what Charles Darwin discovered, was that sometimes the variation gives you an advantage and sometimes it doesn't. So Charles Darwin was traveling around, you probably heard this story, in the islands that we call the Galapagos. And he would get a bird and spend time with the bird studying the shape of its beak. And these are the famous finches of the Galapagos Islands.
Finches play a pivotal role in the history of studying evolution. When Charles Darwin made his famous voyage to the Galapagos Islands, he noticed that there was a surprising variation in the size and shape of the beaks of finches from one island to the next. And that observation played a huge part in developing the theory of evolution.
Ms. Kim has what I think is a very cool demonstration that shows us the nature of getting an advantage by natural selection.
I believe you have some pinto beans in front of you somewhere.
Well, sure, who doesn't?
So this is actually a simulation that I do with my students in my own classroom to demonstrate this concept of genetic variation and competition, and how that eventually can lead to the natural selection of the traits that are more advantageous. You and I, Bill, we're gonna be finches, and we're gonna have beaks in the form of different types of forks. So I know you have some forks lying around somewhere, right? Oh. Let's see how many beans we can move from our plates into our cups in 30 seconds. One fork only, Bill.
Go. I'm a finch, scooping up my beans. I'm a bean scooping finch. I'm using a fork to get my seeds. I'm surviving on a Galapagosian island. I'm beaking around with a fork. I'm competing with other finches as fast as I can.
And stop.
Counting beans.
159.
174.
What? You beat me. So we can pretty clearly see that some of these beaks were better suited to collecting this food than others. If we imagine these as different types of finches competing for food on an island, let's just say things don't look too good for this finch here.
I think the key was the scoopy fork.
Right.
So just think, if your beak was just the right shape, you'd have an advantage over other finches on your island.
What we've seen from this demonstration are two things. The first is called survival of the fittest, which is the continued existence of organisms that are best adapted to their environment with the extinction of others. The second is variation, which is the genetic differences within and among a species or population.
That is a cool demo.
It's a very popular one with the kids too.
I love it. Darwin also talked about artificial selection, and humans do artificial selection all the time. That's why we have farm food, because farmers have artificially selected for the plants that taste the best, that grow the fastest, that are the most drought resistant. So this banana, the kind of banana that we all enjoy, is called a Cavendish, named after Steve Harrelson. No, it's named after a guy named Cavendish. But before these was another bigger and what people say tastier, more banana-like banana. And people called it the Big Mike. The Big Mike was wiped out by a fungus, and we don't have them anymore. So farmers found another banana that we call the Cavendish that can thrive despite that fungus. But keep in mind, right now, these are all cloned. If the bananas are all exactly alike, and there's a germ that can attack this one, it could attack all of these. One of the advantages that you and I have being big animals is that we have variation. It allows us to fight off germs. If you're a big animal, your enemies are not gonna be lions and tigers and bears. What's really scary? Flying monkeys. That's right. If you're not scared of flying monkeys, there's something wrong with you. All right, but the thing that's gonna get you, and we're all living through this right now, germs. Germs are what get us big animals. So by having these genes that are a new combination every time, we have the advantage of having a new combination of genes that the germ, like this virus, may not be able to attack.
So how could the whole human race be wiped out from cloning?
In science fiction stories, people talk about cloning people all the time. We're going to clone them. We're going to make armies of clones who are going to be soldiers to take over the world. You don't want to do that, because instead of coming up with a new combination of genes with a mom and a dad, you're not coming up with a new variation. So if everybody were exactly the same, something like the coronavirus could wipe us all out.
Because everyone on Earth would have the same weaknesses.
And we don't want that. Science! Education is a never-ending journey. So hit the subscribe button so you don't miss an episode of Celebrity Substitute, only on YouTube.